Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and we are finally back playing a finally newly updated Saurian with tons of new and awesome additions to the game. We're going to talk about all of them throughout the video, but this is patch 1.8.274. It adds literally 6 new creatures to the game. That's how big a patch this is. It's like a 50% increase in the number of alive AI driven creatures in the game, which is absolutely insane. I'm sure you'll agree. So we're going to take a quick little look at them in the encyclopedia, and then we're going to hop in game and try to hunt some down for ourselves. So first of all, we have Anyklosaurus Nectens, which is a fairly humongous, as you can tell, sort of twice the size of a human, nearly. Oh, God, look at it, it's an absolute monster. A chungus, I believe, is the meme term these days. I'm down with the kids. It's a big old hadrosaur, basically. It is the quintessential duck-billed dinosaur, basically. It's beautiful. And it's more of an inland dinosaur. The Triceratops favours the coasts. The Anyklosaurus is more inland. So we should see quite a lot of those, because we don't hang around the coast that much. Anyklosaurus is in the game as well. The gorgeously cute and adorable looking Anyklosaurus. Now this Anyklosaurus will look a little bit strange to a lot of you who are accustomed to the Jurassic Park / Jurassic World / media in general version of Anyklosaurus. It's only in the last year or so that this version of Anyklosaurus has kind of become what we think the dinosaur actually looked like. Maybe the last few years, but either way, it's definitely a newer revelation compared to the very big plated back that we associate with the dinosaur in the past. It's very cute though, isn't it? It's still fairly huge. Again, size of human. All of these are dinosaurs that are going to be more than capable of taking down a young Dakotaraptor. Denvosaurus next, another nodosaurid this time. It's the same, it's in the Ankylosaurian family, but it's a nodosaurid, kind of like Polacanthus, for example, in our, in Jurassic World Evolution. We have Didelphodon, which is a tiny little, very first mammal in the game. You know, this is very much towards the end of the Cretaceous period, when mammals were starting to rise up a little bit. It's about the size of a cat. That's going to be a nice little bit of food for our younger Dakotas, I think. We have Lepitosteus, which is our first fish in the game. It's got actual AI. It's going to swim around, and I don't know if we can kill it, but we'll have to find out. And finally, we have AI, passive AI, at least, for the Quetzalcoatlus, which again is fairly humongous. That is very cool. I'm very excited to look up in the sky and see one of these. I don't know if they interact. I don't know if they just hunt fish. I don't know if they kill me. There we go, folks. It's a whole new world. And my little baby Dakota, called Dakota, has entered Hell Creek for the very first time. If you did have a save file, it does appear to have all been wiped, probably because, you know, this update is just absolutely humongous, so the game couldn't really just let us keep our old files. But there's my bro, or sis, or whatever you choose to be. You're probably a little bit young to be choosing your gender at this point. Let's grab a little. Okay, it's actually been a really long time since I played this game, so it might take me a minute to remember how you play the game. We've got some ornithomimids over there, little gallimimus-esques, and we have a little crocodilian at the coastline as well. And, is that a Denvosaurus? I think that's a Denvosaurus. Hello. Now you shouldn't be spooked. Oh my god, you're really cool. You shouldn't be spooked by me. I'm pretty chill. I'm getting a little bit of, not lag, my FPS is solid at like 30-ish, but it's a little bit jumpy. I'm wondering why. That's very cool though. Look at that. Brand new dinosaur, ladies and gentlemen. He's chilling, doing his own thing. Mama, come and kill him, please. Oh, I died. Oh no. Oh, I feel bad for the Denvosaurus must be struggling with that. He's going to get some severe, like, PTSD. He's just walking along. It's like when you're walking down the street, right, and you step on, like, a snail or something, and you kind of feel bad about it. But this is even worse, because I'm sure I felt more pain. Mama, you abandoned me to be my own stupidity. How could you? So before we sort of skip forward and look for all dinosaurs and try to grow up a little bit, I just want to talk briefly about the other stuff added to the game. So amongst all the new AI, there's some new, let's have a little look here. Flooding can now occur after and during rainfall, so that's something we're definitely going to keep a lookout. That's going to be really, really cool. There's hiding AI behavior, so dinosaurs will now hide from you. Opposition dinosaurs will now hide from you. Mama, get him! Get him! Mama got smashed! Well, she died. I'm going to eat her later. There's some ambient sounds. There's new songs, which is good because the nighttime music is terrifying. I'm hoping they've added a new one there. Player can now crouch by holding control, apparently. There we go. Because, you know, hiding's in the game. Like a little ninja. It doesn't really do much when you're a babby, but still. There's a toggleable slow motion effect, new hunting music cue, foliage and tree distance sliders are in the game, blah 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 blah. And then there's a bunch of like minor little changes and just general AI stuff like that. It's, if you want to get into it, you know, go look at the patch notes, but generally speaking the game has just been tightened up a little bit. I really want to eat my parent, but you're kind of... Oh, there's another Denver over there. I want to go look at the... Right, okay. I mean, I don't really need the food right now, but it's just good to know it's there, you know? Maybe he'll go away eventually. Got a severe edible complex, I should say. Right, I'm going for it. Go, feast! Feast upon your parents! Yes, there we go. She sacrificed herself nobly so that I may live forever. Hello, cheeky. I get him. Oh, I got him! I can't remember what this little guy's called. It's the seabird, anyway, so we must not be that far from the coast, in theory. Oh, here we go, folks. Just stumbled across a little herd. I say little. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 of them, at least, of the Anatosaurus. So we're going to approach very... You know what we're going to do? We're going to save it, because if a Denvosaurus can crush me underfoot, then the Anatosaurus can definitely crush me underfoot. So there we go. All right, we're going to approach with relative caution. Zooming out is being very weird today. There we go. Hello. You see, we've actually got some sexual dimorphism here, where I'm going to assume it's the males with the brighter head colouring, but you can see there is actually a difference between the two. What are you doing, son? What are you playing at? You've gone bloody mental, lad. I don't think it's just the colour of the head either. The body itself seems to be maybe a little bit lighter. It's sort of a darker shade. You see, this is the male, that's the female. I'm assuming, anyway. You compare those two there. It seems just a little bit. I could be entirely wrong, but it seems to be the case. Hello. Oh, these are humongous. I'm very excited to maybe get to an adult and try to take one of these big boys down. Or big girls, whatever. I'm not gonna discriminate. I will murder everybody. I feel very small right now, it must be said. They're a little bit janky. They appear to be like... having a coughing fit every now and again. I'm not sure that's... Ooh. Oh, is it raining? I think it's raining. Now, the raining graphic has apparently been changed a little bit. I can't say I know it well enough that I will actually be able to tell you what's changed. But the exciting thing about this is that we really want to see what the flooding is as well. So hopefully that actually happens. I don't think it's a guarantee. Oh, no. It just takes an inch, ladies and gentlemen. It only takes an inch. That's what you used to tell my ex-girlfriends, in a way. Okay, folks, I just want to show you something else. There's been like a slow motion thing added again. I'm going to save it because I've got no idea what I'm about to try to kill, and I want to make sure I'm ready. But if you press right trigger, right click, I should say, you kind of zoom in on your Dakotaraptor's face. It's lovely, but the best thing about it is it also, as you see when we jump, it gives you like a slow motion mode. So this might be a really good way of getting up close with a creature. Now, this is of course a creature I don't really want to get up close with, but I just want to be able to see it, you know, like this, and then we can run away. See, a good way of looking at dinosaurs and stuff, and Gila monsters. And I just want to show you that. I've got no idea what's going on with the zooming. I really don't. I have to scroll back like 10,000 times for anything to happen. It's very weird. Looking a little... grown up a little bit. You remember the last... The problem seems to be that it can't zoom out. When you've fully zoomed in, it can't zoom back out until you zoom all the way out. Until you've zoomed all the way out, kind of thing, and then it jumps. You can zoom in little iterations like this, but you can't zoom out in iterations. It has to jump out like that. So that's definitely a bug. Hopefully it gets fixed. Oh, hello. Cheeky little herbivore friend over there. Let's go say hello, because I need some food. Remember the last video we did on this game was when they added the... basically, your dinosaur used to go to sleep and it would jump up in size and shape and all this kind of and like formation, morphology, basically. And now it no longer does that. The dinosaurs grow and change and develop over time. It's a really, 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 really cool system. That is very hard to notice. We did a time lapse in the last video. If you haven't checked it out already, go check out my Saurian playlist. It'll be in there. It'll be in the description of this video as well. Oh, I can zoom out. Nice. Only in the water. Oh, no, it's broken. Nope, it's definitely a bit weird, but that's all right. It's definitely worth checking out. We did a little time lapse, and you can see how the dinosaur changes over time. Like, instead of jumping, it's like bloop, bloop, bloop. Kind of like, I think Prehistoric Kingdom has the same kind of thing going on, although at a simpler level. Where's my little Herbie? There it is. There it is. Right, we're going to crouch. Okay, we're going to get a little closer, and then we're going to crouch. A little closer. Oh, hello. What's this? Am I crouching? I'm not. We got ourselves a little mammal right here. I'm nearly dead. Oh, it's squaring up to me. Oh my god, it's gonna kill me. Run away! Run, little Dakota! I was not prepared for this. I thought it'd be an easy kill. Okay, we're gonna save it. I may have absolutely no health whatsoever, but we're gonna save it. The idea is to steal his little mammalian kill. Although he's going back to it. Why have you been murdering the mammals? You're a herbivore, you cheeky little so-and-so. It's dead, right? Oh, it's not dead! Ah! I've murdered his pet! He's not happy about it. Alright. Just, how old am I? I've not aged up yet. I just want to look at the corpse, okay? It's not a fetish, but... I mean, it's slightly a fetish. I feel like something's trying to kill me. I'm sorry! We can be friends! I'm gonna stay crouched. I want my dinner! Go away! Maybe it wasn't the best time to save. In retrospect, okay, I think it's moved far enough away. There it is. Right? Is it there? There it is. Look, boop. Now we can zoom in and get like a proper look at the corpse. This is nice. If you're into, oh my god, it's okay. It's a little difficult to control. There we go. Look at that, beautiful. Nom 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 nom. Nom nom nom. Good stuff. See, we can be friends. We could be lovers. Well, maybe not lovers, but we can be friends. The game actually used to be... It's weird to say this. The game actually used to be much easier than it is now. You can see how my stomach is full, right? So even if I lose food, you know, at least for these next sort of 10 seconds or so, I can't lose food, basically, because I'm still digesting the contents of my stomach. But it used to be that that bar there, that sort of mossy... runoffy greeny brown sort of colour would degrade at about your normal food rate. So you essentially had two food bars as long as you could find enough food to fill both of them up. And it meant food was just never an issue, really. Oh, hello. Next growth stage, let's go. Go to sleep. Adorable. Absolutely adorable. I want some rainfall and I want an Anyklosaurus. I'm not looking for much, but those are my two goals right now. There we go, they look lovely. The Dakotaraptor can take down larger prey with raptor prey restraint. Jump onto an animal to initiate RPR. Once mounted, flap to maintain your balance by clicking R&B and damage your prey by clicking L&B. I've got to be honest, that's something I've never ever got the whole, like, I've never really got the hang of the RPR. It's definitely something I'd like to get good at. So what I'm going to do is aim for a fully grown Dakota and then we'll find something a little bit bigger to take down and we'll do some practice. We'll see if we can do it. Hello. There's all a bunch of you, isn't there? Right, can I kill you now? Let's find out. Ow! Ow! Alright! Cheeky little so-and-so. Okay, we're gonna save it. I need some food. Come here. Let me at him. Let me at him. Dum dum dum. I mean, it's very cool, the dramatic zoom in slow motion, but it feels... I'm clearly not capable. Oh, I just suck. It's one of those two. Still not Ankylosaurus, but I have found another herd of Anatosauruses, so we're gonna go take a look because they're just pretty cool. We are currently about, you know, 1 and 2 thirds. Now, we don't jump up again, I believe, until age 3 and then age 5 or something like that. I can't quite remember, but we're doing okay. We're alive. That's what matters. I mean, we're playing on casual difficulty. The game is very easy on this difficulty. These are very strange. Like little fingers, little penises. Well, comparatively rather large, I guess, but all pointing angrily towards the sky. It's like a ritual. Oh, there's more of them. Oh, it's actually kind of spooky. Right. Natto's friends, I'm going to save the game because you're definitely going to murder me. Like every other dinosaur in the bloody game does. How are we doing? We good? Zoom in a little bit. There we go. Look at that. It's a very cool looking dinosaur. Like I said, the animations do seem a little janky to me. I don't know what that's meant to be there. I mean, that clearly is on purpose. It's just very strange. We're just gonna try something here. We can, in theory, try to kill one. And then we can run away very fast, right? It should work. So, I just want to check flap. The raptor restraint is really just never really explained in this game. Let's go for it. What the hell just happened? I mean, I'm climbing a tree, which I always enjoy. It's cool. It's a cool feature. But what the hell just happened? Seriously. What was that? I jumped, and suddenly my character, my little Dakota, was a million miles away. How weird. I didn't know you could... Well, that was awkward. I was going to save this for a little bit later, but considering it's going mental right now, I figured I'd show you guys. The game... I mentioned before that Saurian does have a bit of a habit of doing this, you know, when the game patches, it tends to break a little bit. It feels, at times at the moment, nearly unplayable. The lag is a big issue, more than anything else. You know, I'm not seeing it right now, but it's not FPS lag. You know, my PC is quite strong, it shouldn't be an issue. Yet it jumps constantly, it gets these weird little stutters constantly, and every now and again when I'm walking, or indeed as you just saw, swimming, it just goes absolutely mental, and I don't really know why. My character kind of keeps descending into the earth like she's trying to return to hell for some reason. Oh, hello, cheeky. It's very, very strange. You'll see it, it's just as I'm running along, look. Just jumps like that. And this is with low graphic settings and a very powerful PC. You know, I've knocked them down quite a lot. Definitely not on max settings or anything like that. So I don't really think there's any excuse for this. And I think it's definitely something that's going to need to get sorted in a patch, unfortunately. We need some bug fixing. I have yet to find an Anyklosaurus. I've seen Anyklosauruses, I've seen Triceratopses, I've seen Tyrannosaurus Rexes. I've not actually seen another Denver either, but the Denver and the Anki just appear to be incredibly rare. I haven't spotted either of them in the last, God knows how long I've been doing this now, probably an hour or something like that, and I haven't seen any of them. I'm not going to give up. I'm going to find an Anyklosaurus, and we're leveling up anyway. We're nearly age 3 now, you know, we're getting a little bit older. And I won't give up, folks. I won't give up. I have seemingly found myself to about the edge of the map. I don't think I can get any further over this way. Clearly, you know, this is an unworked little area. There's no trees, there's no plants. But there is this. Now, I know this is nothing in reality, but from a distance, I got this proper, like, alien-esque vibe. Now, that's not the kind of game this is ever going to be. I'm not really sure what this is about. It's the basis of something just, like, a little under... But it's a bit weird, isn't it? It definitely has, like, an alien... Prometheus sort of marking kind of look to it. My little Dakotaraptor is a little bit suspicious. Just a little bit. I'm going to save it quickly. We're going to go hang out with the Anyklosaurus again. I still cannot find a Anyklosaurus. I'm sure they exist, and I'm going to keep going. I was going to do 2 videos today, but I think I might have to do 1 video today. But the Anyklosauruses are very cool at the very least. Tell you what, we're going to try to kill one. Now, last time we tried this, it went disastrously badly. Not because they killed me, but because the game broke. Let's try again. Hit. Well, that went well. Hit. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, finally we have an Ankylosaurus. I am 5.5 years old. I've been playing this game for literally, I don't know the timing. It's something like an hour and a half though. I've got the football up on the other screen, right? And we're about 55, 60 minutes in. So that's at least an hour. And I started this at least 20 minutes before that. So we're talking near enough an hour and a half no matter what, if not a little bit more. And I finally found an Ankylosaurus. I really had to get away from the water as much as possible. I've been trying to do that for the entire thing, don't get me wrong, because it did say it preferred not to hang around near the water. You know, it wasn't a coastal dinosaur like the Triceratops. But there it is. It's a shame it's not the daytime, because that would have been cool, but it's still very cool. It's very cute. I am going to try to kill it, but we're going to save it beforehand because I'm not absolutely bloody mental. So save. Okay, my plan is to just attack it from the front, basically, and stay away from the tail. I'm just going to do... what's it going to do if I do this? Stupid Ankylosaurus. Oh god, I've got hiccups. I've been playing for so long, I've managed to develop illnesses. Oh, there's a T-Rex. Oh, okay. Okay. I don't... Okay, we're going to end it there because we've seen everything. We've not seen the Quetzalcoatlus. I think they may have already been in the game. They just didn't have AI in the past. One day we'll head to the coast and try to spot them. But I've been playing for a long, long time. I actually need to get the video done and uploaded. Like I say, I was planning to do two videos today, but I quite literally do not have the time because it's taken so long just to show you guys this little Ankylosaurus. I just wanted to... I committed to the idea, you know. I wasn't willing to give up on it once I'd kind of committed to the notion. And it is very, very cool. If a little... uninteractive, it just does not care about my existence, does it? Oh my god, the game's crashed. Has the game crashed? Yeah, the game has some severe problems right now. It's jumping all over the place. It's crashed on me 2 or 3 times. That's another reason I don't really want to continue. I feel like I'm battling against the game. The music is jumping constantly. It's not like an FPS issue because the music itself is reacting. It's getting really frustrating. So hopefully this gets patched relatively soon. I can come back in. We can look at more dinosaurs. I've shown everything anyway, basically. We'll head over to the coast, have a few laughs, look for the Quetzalcoatlus, all that kind of stuff. But until then, we're just going to end it there. Saurian people, if you're watching, the game needs a little bit of work, okay? But this is kind of what you expect when you first play a Saurian patch, is the way it is. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen, on this awkward little adventure. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.